Chicago. 25 or 624. Not two, the number, granted. It is T-O, in case you didn't know that. And in case you didn't know, this is Geoff the Angry Man Garlock, and I am flying solo, baby. That is right. And you are stuck right dab in the middle of the sleepy time sojourn, nighttime, overnight block. Right here on 108.9 The Hawk, and I am all alone here. Jason Gore, my best friend, my co-pilot in life, he didn't make it here tonight, and he ain't dead. He's not dead. I swear to you. Did have massive food poisoning, though. I told him to stay away from the chili, but he went for it. We, of course, were down at Poughkeepsie's Bar and Grill over there on Hog Street, and a big truck was running the chili eat-off down there, and I tell you, no one ate as much. As well, Big Truck won that one. He set up the account, and he got the competition going. Jason didn't even come close. He ate half a bowl, took him down for the count. But we're sending good thoughts out to him. Of course, I'm so now I'm here alone. We were gonna do this. It was gonna be a little fun thing. We're gonna do the overnight drive time, because of course we're gonna do this like we're gonna treat it like a church lock-in. You ever go to a church lock-in when you go there and you go to the church and it's unclear why it's religious exactly, but you get locked in and eventually you hope to touch a breast. I mean, again, it's not very religious. You're just in that church. The people who are in charge have gone to sleep. Eventually that bottle comes out and you start spinning it. And you don't want it to land on you, because then you've got to be the one that admits that... This might be your first time. And then, you end up in a closet. Some bad things happen, or good things, depending on how you look at it. That's church for you. You know, that's a good summary of church. We're having fun here, though. This is, of course, Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. And I am all alone here, just listening to Chicago. Listen to those spooky, spooky horns. Of course, if you're not here, and usually, again, I am like, really alone here. Usually I got Jason on my side. He's helping out. Usually I got Scotty, the engineer. Scotty, you know what I'm talking about? No, he ain't there. Don't even see him shaking his head no at me. I can imagine he's in the middle of his slumber himself, just shaking his head no at me. Maybe I've integrated into his dreams. But that's besides the point. But what I'm saying here is I'm all alone. Station manager Ron needed this to happen tonight. Needed someone to take over the shift. We thought it would be a fun bonding experience of friends, but Jason's having a bonding experience with his toilet, I'm guessing right about now. We're just having fun here. I'm having fun, but the phone lines are open, people. I got three more hours on this shift. I can't believe I got to fill that entire time, of course, with wonderful classic rock. But we're going to have fun here, though. Make sure you dial up. I know most of you people are sleeping. Maybe some late night truckers out there buying their fifth bottle of trucker speed. You can maybe give me a ring here at 555-5545-5444-555. That, of course, last couple five spells out overnight, spelled with a dollar sign. 108.9 The Hawk, we are here. And you know, the thing about dollar signs, if I may vamp a little bit, and I will, the thing about dollar signs is, what is money? Now I'm just talking here. You know, what is really this world of ours that is based on cash and based on a monetary system? I'm not going to lie, I kind of started that idea and realized that that's where I was expecting Jason. Usually I'm used to him. I'm used to him just jumping and going, "You're right, Geoff, that's a great concept." And you know what I like about money? Pink Floyd's money. But I'm all alone, I'm running the boards here. You know, I was a skater for a while. Most people don't know that about Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. I used to really enjoy competitive skating. I'm not going to say I was on the way to the Olympics, but I was getting there. And then my leg got taken. I'm sorry. I'm not going to lie. I'm getting It's a little spooky here. It's a little spooky in the studio. I've never been here alone. Never been surrounded by the haunting and the creaking. Not gonna lie to you too, I've been watching a lot of those Blumhouse movies lately. The Conjuring and that dumb one about the doll. What is that, Annabelle? Ugh. It's creepy, though, I gotta say. I wouldn't mind the Warrens showing up here. Some of that herky-jerky horror there to protect me. But, you know, that's fine. I'm here with classic rock and, you know, just maybe call in. Give a call and tell me, what do you like about the night? What scares you about the night? What haunts you about the night? What keeps you up at night? What makes it so that it's hard for you to sleep at night? What makes it that you wake up at around 2:30, 3 a.m., turn on 108.9 The Hawk to make sure that the great existential maw of existence doesn't suck you into its ever-gnashing teeth, just hoping that they're playing Chicago 25 or 6-4 on 108.9 The Hawk? Share me your dreams. Share me your nightmares. I'm here for you, people. I'm here for you to also explain to me what's up with those horns at the end of that song. Chicago, I mean, you guys are supposed to be good horn players. That is a piercing, haunting horn sound. That second note, that can't be right. Any musicologists out there who can talk to me about that? I mean, I just love classic rock. I could just speak from it from my soul. But if there's someone out there who could actually explain to me, is that how a horn is supposed to be played? Because I'm not going to lie to you. I don't think they know what they're doing. Ugh. Anyways, I digress. Geoff the Anger Man, Garlock here at 108.9 The Hawk and the sleep and slumber overnight drive time, night overshift, drive shift. Look, you just give a call in. Numbers wide open, 555-545-5445-5445-5445. Of course, that does mean overnight. Second number is a dollar sign. And anything you want to talk about, I'm here for you. I'm here to keep you up. Here to keep me up. Oh, we got one. Line, hold on. Scotty. Shit, I forgot. Sorry, Scotty's not here. Probably shaking his head no in his nightmares. All right, I think this is two. I'm going to hit line two. Hey, how you doing? This is Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. Welcome to One Away Boy Died the Hawk. Who's there?
Okay, Delaware, Todd's here. You get an order for pickup. Yeah, I'm probably going to do the number three, the Delaware Todd. You know, does that have pickles? Because okay. I'm deathly allergic to pickles. Like, bad.
All right,
stuff
so now I'm gonna stop you right there. I think you might have the wrong number. This is 108.9 The Hawk, Val Verde's greatest classic rock station. Were you trying to place an order?
Wait, this is The Hawk?
Oh, yes,
man, that station blows, man.
Oh, wow.
I'm a squirt man through and through. You know, they're back. It's sounding good. This is just, what did you just play, Chicago or something? I'm not even listening. I'm guessing you guys played some garbage like Chicago where I just turn over to the squirt and they're probably playing like, you know, Hendrix Watchtower or something. Anyway, I'll take the number four. That's the Delaware Todd.
Okay.
I would like to have the pickles removed. As I said, it really gives me a rash. Just like not even one that you would look at and you'd be like, that's not a rash. That's
all right. I'm gonna write this down.
Leprosy.
Just to have the order, just in case. But again, a Delaware Todd, no pickles, gives
no
you
pickles.
A rash. Don't want to see it.
Looks like leprosy.
Looks like leprosy. Yeah. All right. But again, don't know why I'm writing this down. You verified that you know you are talking to a classic rock station.
Wait, which station was it again?
108.9 The Hawk.
Oh, God, they're the fucking worst, man.
No, we went through this. Are we in a time loop with here? No. Yes. I'm sorry. If you want a Delaware Todd.
Who's this? What's your name, man? Because I'm, you know.
Yeah, who am I speaking to here? This is Geoff the Anger Man Garlock.
Hey,
who are you?
You can just call me Cheese. That's what everyone calls me. And this is the time I'm up at night, man. When you're in bed, like, you know, at night. When not you, obviously. You know, you're a loser like me. You're up. And, when you're, you know, the day walkers, you know what I mean, man?
Wow.
Out and about,
Jeez, I'm gonna take a wild stab in the dark here. I thought maybe
don't
I was
do
gonna
that,
guess.
Man, because that's how people get hurt. And that's what I went to jail for. I took a wild stab in the dark.
Oh, wow. You went
to jail. Thought I was alone, man. Thought I was alone. I was in a cabin out in the woods. Was pretty sure I was the only one there. I took a wild stab, and I killed a park ranger.
I'm not going to lie. Jeez, this story is getting more. I was going to try to let you go, but instead, I had a simple guess that you were just
Pepsi.
A...
Pepsi'd be good.
Okay, again, I don't even know what restaurant you're ordering a Delaware Todd. You know that we don't have Pepsi in Val Verde. That is, we've been banned from Pepsi. Worst.
Why do I live here, man? I tell you why I live here, because 98.6 is Squirt. They've got everything for me, man. I'm a Squirt, man. Gush, gush, right? Squirt, squirt.
Okay, we can't...
through and through.
Can't be promoting here. So, I'm sorry, cheese. I was going to guess that you were just a Reddit nerd who lived in your mother's basement.
Oh,
but...
Reddit, man. That's for fucking nerds. You know what? I'm dark web through and through.
Oh, okay, so you are dark... Because I was getting worried that you were actually weirdly admitting you were a vampire.
No, I'm a vampire killer, man. What did you think? I took a wild stab in the dark. The park ranger was a vampire.
Well, this is just getting interesting.
I have these conversations on the Squirt. We're in and out, and I've got my Papa Roach, and I'm just having to lay everything on the table for a hawk, man. Who is? Which one of you hawk nerds is this? Is this that Turlington?
No,
what's his full name?
Not Wisp.
That's an old bastard
Turlington.
That needs to shut up. He needs to shut his mouth, man.
Wisp is still in South America. He went back there post July 4th. He just didn't want to celebrate America.
Let me just say, man, he's a little bit on my radar. Just saying, because he's real fucking old. He feels a little immortal. I'm just going to lay it out there. So the pickles, again, don't nowhere near.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm running out of ink in this pen. And again, I don't even know what restaurant you've been trying to order from.
Delaware Todd's, man. Best sandwiches in Verde.
Oh, I said Delaware
that at the
Todd's.
I said, is this Delaware Todd's? And then I placed my order.
Yes, I know, but because you're a Val Verde resident, the Delaware Todd is just like the fat cat sandwiches over by Rutgers University in New Jersey. That's our version. The Delaware Todd, of course, for people if you're driving through, because we got a lot of truckers who drive through Val Verde.
You're driving through, man. Just keep on passing through unless you want to hear some good rock, and then you turn it over to
Don't say it. The Delaware Todd is a sandwich where we put literally everything on a sandwich.
In a cum accident, man, and then they came back even stronger. Even stronger. Whatever you want, whatever you think your station's going to do for you, they're never going to do that, man.
Right,
you ever come back? Have you ever come back from a cum accident, man?
Once. Right.
Well,
yes.
Then you know what I'm talking about. Squish, squish. Hey, squish. So 30 minutes. If you want directions, you know, there's an old, lonely old man at the bottom of the road. He's going to tell you to go on up the road. I'm in cabin number 3. It's one with all the stab marks right around the door.
Oh, Creepy Joe. Yes. I try to stay away from Creepy Joe. Creepy
cabin
Joe.
Cabin 2, man. I'm cabin 3.
Yeah, I know. And I'm not going to.
Cabin 2 is all. I have the stab marks, man. Cabin 3. I talked to the Squirt, and they fucking just write it down.
Jeez,
man.
I was excited about you. I'm letting you go, but I'll do you a solid, and I'll call Delaware Todd's
you. Man. Get on that shit. Fuck.
All right. Thank you, cheese. Ugh, people. Well, that's the type of fun we're gonna have here when I'm alone on 108.9 The Hawk. I gotta say, we got a lot of information that cheese. Might as well call him Barry the Lead on what his deal is. Vampire Hunter, which also is starting to make me... Nope, we got another call. Scotty? Nope, not there again. Shoot. I'm going to dial 3. Yes, hello. Welcome to 108.9 The Hog. This is Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. Who are we talking to right now?
Is this 108.9 The Hog? I'd like to hear a good rock song. One from... Little Red Zeppelin. Can we hear some Zeppelin?
I'm sorry. Wisp, is that you?
I'll take lunch in the foyer.
Yeah.
In the foyer. Oh, no, Wisp. This is Jameson's.
Jameson's. That's the best you could come up with, Wisp.
This is Jameson's, man, calling in to see what's going on. The foyer.
All right. All right, I'll play along. All right.
I'm going to eat beef tenderloin in the backyard.
Maybe you should get a Delaware Todd's.
Nah, those are bad sandwiches. That's pure, pure diarrhea in a paper bag.
That is the tagline for Delaware Todd's, pure
it's
diarrhea in a paper
tagline.
Bag.
Tagline. I mean, the ad agency that gave it that immediately went out of business, but they kept it on the bags, and disgusting. Not eating that garbage. It's pure garbage. What's it like sitting in the big seat all alone in there? You scared? I bet you're scared. Ooh.
All right. I mean, it is.
Creeping from the corners. I'm in the shadows. I'm under your chair.
Okay. Jameson's. Quote unquote. Can you stop trying to freak me out here?
No, man. I wouldn't do that. I'm calling in. I really love to hear something. You know, I was thinking Zeppelin at first, but you know what? Let's hear the best record. I want to hear something off of Outrider from a guy I would love to meet sometime, Jimmy Page. And we'll play that, and it'll be nice. And,
All right.
Be scary. Like, every single crack, you're like,
okay,
what's that?
I'm not going to lie, Jamesons. It feels
Jamesons.
Like you're trying to freak me out. And whoa.
Oh, geez. No. I wouldn't do that.
Did you hear that behind me?
No,
did you hear that, guitar solo right
not
behind?
Not a thing, man. Not a thing.
It sounded like I'm gonna go crazy here. Sound like In the Shadows by the records. I heard the Death Wish 2 soundtrack playing behind me.
Lame.
I'm just saying it. It's what
I didn't mean that to you. My person was saying strawberry daiquiri, and I don't. Who drinks a strawberry daiquiri? You mix that with a pina colada, and you call it the lava flow, and I'll have two of those in the foyer with the beef tenderloin. God damn it! Anyway, yeah, this is a man named Jamesons.
All right, Jamesons. I'm starting to. I'm hearing noises because of you, and I don't think it's because of you. I wish you wouldn't call in to try to creep me out, Jamesons.
You ever listen to those old, like those creepy late night shows on radio where they talk about vampires and like ghouls and goblins and stuff like that? And then the music, when they come back from commercial, it's usually like a catheter commercial where they're like, these catheters do themselves. They go right up the hole and they pull it out all by themselves. Usually a game show host talking about it, or that guy that played second fiddle on Home Improvement, Richard Karn.
Richard Karn, one of the
not a friend.
Don't trust any ad that Richard Karn is behind. Yeah, I don't know if it's a Pavlovian response, but I feel freaked out. I feel like I'm going to hear about the darkest conspiracies that exist out there in the world.
Also,
like listening to an Art Bell broadcast.
That's exactly what I'm talking about, like that's one of those things. But I do have to say, since we said Richard Karn, do you ever think that the name Richard Karn was just built for prog rock?
Karn number 9. Do you think that Emerson, Lake & Palmer's song was about Richard Karn?
Do you think there have been 9 Richard Karns?
Oh, well,
and
now.
And the 9th one is the most evil? And then sometime, it's going to show its ass. It's going to try to take over the fucking world. And then Karns 1 through 8 are going to have to bond together to take down Richard Karn number 9.
I mean, Jameson's, are you coming up with this off the top of your dome, or is this something that
possible.
You're telling me the truth here of what could be happening?
Saying it's a possibility. Hold on, who's a game show host? Give me a game show host name.
Art Linkletter.
And these catheters are the best. I'm Art Linkletter for lick 'em up catheters, and then the music's like. And that lasts for literally 3 minutes before they even start talking about aliens playing with buttholes.
And that's what, are you just giving me career advice here? Is that you telling me this is what I should be doing right now, Jamesons? I don't like any of this.
Now you say, we're back. And we're here with alien expert
Johnny B. Good.
Johnny B. Good is my name. Dude, we'll play this here.
You're testing me out here?
Let's start this from the beginning. Here we go.
Okay. And we're back with, of course, we are at the Smart Smells conspiracy hour, late time talk now show here. We are, of course, talking about the UFO phenomena. We are talking about the UFO truth. We are talking to a real expert here, a ufologist, a true hero for America, Richard Karn.
What? No, I'm Johnny B. Good.
Oh, God. See, I'm not made for this. Fuck. God damn it. I'm sorry, Jameson.
Oh, my God. I'm hanging up.
No, you have me freaked out. Oh, my God. All right, I'm going to just say it. That was Wisp. That was Wisp screwing with me. But also, was he screwing with me? I mean, I felt like he was putting me to the test. I also don't know why he's away and he's calling in just to either mess with me or just get Led Zeppelin songs played or Outrider. Oh, goodness. All right, well, that's going to be something we have to figure out when we come back. Because this is 108.9 The Hawk, and this is Tom Petty.
Climbing up on Sal's mistake, I could see the gravy boats. We were always eating steak anytime that we won.
Hello, I'm Peter Gabriel for Shawnees, reminding you that you can come down and enjoy our brand new Salisbury Steak Buffet for a limited time only at your local Shawnees or in the United Kingdom, your local Gabriel's. Only for a limited time. No one eats for free, as all of the proceeds from this will support WOMAD.
My heart going steak, steak, steak. Hey, he said, grab your fork, I've come to take you home.
Please do not forget your fork.
Yeah, your fork.
Only at Shawnee's and in the UK at Gabriel's. Salisbury Steak, the buffet, for a limited time. No one eats for free at Shawnee's.
No one eats for free at Shawnee's.
Four ex-CIA operatives turn Philadelphia cops turn garbage men who take out the trash. Literally and figuratively. Robert Ginty, Treat Williams, Powers Booth, and Steve James are the Garbage Men. On the Channel 8 Action Afternoon Blowout. Channel 8, your home for great shit.
Hawk Overnights. Literally no one is listening. 108.9, The Hawk.
Midnight Rider by the Allman Brothers Band. I tell you, those brothers, just like Chicago, freak me out, I gotta say. I don't know if it's all these calls I've been getting. I don't know if it's that I'm alone in the studio here. And now I feel like I am hearing the combination of the haunting melodies of Jimmy Page dicking around on the Death Wish 2 soundtrack. Now that sounds definitely like a ghost behind me. Or is it Dwayne Allman playing his slide guitar? Because he sometimes hits some notes that feel ghostly. Am I the only one that feels like there's a ghost? Okay, no. That's definitely a ghost. Oh, wait a second. Who is Art?
Oh, hey, why are you in here?
Art Spart, what are you doing here? I'm doing the overnights. What are you doing here?
This is where I sleep. I'm waking up to do traffic. And
Just stay here the entire time that the station is running just so you can do your traffic reports?
Does traffic ever really truly sleep, Geoff?
Oh, wow.
Does traffic sleep? Answer me that.
No. I mean, that is a very deep question, and that's for greater philosophers than me, possibly, but I'll say no, it doesn't.
Well, it doesn't sleep, and really, honestly, neither does Art Spart anymore, because there is some truly dark, dark stuff in the world right now, including all the chimeras than you could think of, and all of the creatures and everything, they're really converging on Val Verde at this moment. So that's, I stay okay, here and I do my traffic and I kind of keep an eye on the Wolfman, if you know what I mean. And I don't mean that as a euphemism for saying drugs. I'm saying I'm literally keeping my eye on the Wolfman. Thank you
for that. Second off, is Wolfman a euphemism for drugs? Is that something anyone has agreed upon?
Oh, I think everybody's saying, like, I'm going to go out to the club. This is what I imagine the kids today are saying. They're saying, I'm going to go to the club, but before that, I have to do a little meeting with the Wolfman. We're going to howl at the moon, and then I'll see you at the club, and we'll dance to all the hit tracks.
Oh, I tell you, I mean, I claim to know a lot about classic rock. I don't know about the vernacular of the children, but you seem to have your finger on the pulse
really
of the youth of America.
I do
like the Art Smart TikTok. I have been checking that out recently.
Thank you.
It's very,
really
very smart stuff you've been doing.
Well, you know, you have to keep up because monsters, they're just getting younger.
I'm
they
glad you brought that back.
Getting younger.
That is very true. Speaking of young monsters, number three.
Here we go.
Can I maybe get a swig of that? I'm starting to be freaked
Absolutely
out there.
Absolutely not. This
All
was,
right, thanks for nothing,
This
Art.
Was blessed by His Holiness himself when I visited Rome last week.
Oh, you went the Pope.
The Pope.
Pope John Paul II, of course, is the Pope. It was the ghost of Pope John Paul II. I remember you telling me the story.
I was down in the catacombs, and I had my bottle of water, and he was like, he made the hand motion like he wanted to make holy water, and I'm like, I hand it back over, and then boom, holy water, and I'm going to be safe for another week.
There are two universal languages, love and holy water. Now, Art, I have to say the third thing, I'm glad you're here. One, because you're not a ghost. I was getting scared there. But two, I had a caller here. I've been alone. I had a caller from, I don't know if you know, a man named Cheese.
Cheese.
Let me give you two other descriptive words for Cheese.
Okay.
Vampire hunter.
Ah, Cheese. Very, he's learning. He's learning. I'm really like his, you know, if they were going to make another Van Helsing movie, and let's just say they try to make it right this time, because let's say they totally blew their load on the first one, and none of it really made any sense. If they make another Van
Helsing...
Let's just say that. And let's just say the studios, they're sitting at the studios right now, and they're looking at all of the scripts on the table, and they're like, none of these work. What if
they're
we did?
Looking
another,
in the IP folder. Gotta check out that IP folder.
Old IP folder. And they're like, what if we do another Van Helsing, but we make it accurate? And this time, Van Helsing is a traffic DJ on a failing classic rock station as part of a failing radio cluster. And he's got kind of a young protege, his Padawan, if you will. And that Padawan probably would be Cheese. He probably would be. But you know what? He doesn't really, he has to focus. A lot of flailing, a lot of just stabbing wherever he wants to stab. And you have to be precise with every stab. That's the Art Smart way.
Wow. So I'm glad I'm talking to you. So you're saying, because you are, of course, a cryptozoologist and one of the best damn traffic people in the world.
That's just the side gig.
But you are also a vampire hunter. Why didn't you told us this before, Art?
Well, have we had a vampire in the studio? Answer is no, because if we would have, I would have slayed them immediately.
Not gonna lie, I got very scared there for a second.
We had Kirk Cameron in the studio, and I gotta tell you,
if there's one person I'm gonna guess is gonna be a vampire. Heard you laugh before, Art. That is not what I expected out of that mouth of yours.
You know, it's late at night. This is the true Art Smart. A little bit, you know, I get a little time to relax. I usually shut my eyes between 1 a.m. and 1:45. And then I get up, I make a big old pot of coffee, I drink it down, I make another big old pot of coffee, I drink it down, I make another big old pot of coffee, I drink it down, and then I make a pot of coffee for you guys when you're coming into the studio, and we're ready to do the 108.9 The Hawk Morning Show. And Yeah, that's pretty much my day.
I gotta say, thank you for the coffee. Number numero uno
you are
there.
Welcome.
Let me guess. Let me guess. Just I don't know if
we're
I like making
a lot
you
of
laugh.
Fun here,
we are having a lot of fun here. I'm glad. Honestly, though, I'm glad someone is here, especially that it's you, because I have been freaked out this whole. What? What
Did
is that
you
looking?
Hear that?
I mean, I.
That was a creek, and where there's a creek, there's the wolf man.
Oh, Art's doing drugs. Yep. He's that's just a euphemism right there. Oh, hold on a second. Art, you got to hold off on doing those drugs there for a second, because I got a call here. Hello. Welcome to 108.9 The Hawk. This is Geoff, the Angry Man Garlock, along with Art Spart, cryptozoologist and vampire hunter and best damn traffic in the biz. Who are we talking to today?
You have a collect call from Val Verde Correctional. Do you accept the charges?
I mean, this one's going on station manager run, right? Yeah, I'll accept the charges. Go for it. Hello?
108.9 The Hawk.
Yes, this is 108.9 The Hawk, and who am I speaking to right now?
Call me Vladimir.
Fair enough, Vladimir. Wait, what you got? You calling in to tell me about your dark secrets? You tell me about a request?
What is the topic tonight?
I mean, I gotta say, we have been all over the place tonight. We have been talking about UFOs. We've been talking about Van
Ooh.
Helsing.
Ooh.
We've been talking about vampire hunters.
I thought for a second you were going to say you were talking about Van Halen. The only thing I like to talk about, and I got excited.
I mean, we can. I mean, we were about to talk about Karn, number 9. Not Richard Karn, of course, ELP, but we can talk about Van Halen, sure.
Good.
All right, so what do you got?
What is the topic on the table referring to Van Halen?
Art, does this voice sound familiar here? I'm not going to lie to you. It just sounds.
I never heard this voice in my life. Never, okay. Ever, 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 never, ever, 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 ever. Never, never, ever, never, ever,
all
ever,
right,
never.
Yeah, I got you. I got
ever.
You, Art.
Not
all
once,
right.
Not twice, not three times.
Okay, it was a creepy
a voice.
That's
I've
why
heard.
I was asking here, Art. I just
all
want
right,
to I'll, know if you recognize this voice.
Well, the Wolfman has been dispatched, and I'm going to be back here on the couch because it is 1:32, and that's
right.
Still Art Smart nap time.
All right, Vladimir, sorry, it's just you and me there. Art has done drugs, I believe. But yeah, so Van Halen. All right, let's talk Van
What's
Halen.
What's the Van Halen topic?
Who is your favorite singer in Van Halen?
Whoa.
Only right answers, if you know what I mean. Oh, this is a tough one for you, Vlad, huh?
Oh, God, this is the worst question you could have asked me, because there are definitely qualities in each one.
Oh my God.
One, showman that David Lee Roth was from 78 to 84.
You all right there, Vlad?
No, let me talk on the phone.
Oh, it sounds like we're having a struggle. Vladimir is getting... Are you getting pulled away by a guard? You are, of course, getting called from a... Oh, my goodness. What was that?
There was nothing.
I'm not... It sounded like you broke someone's neck.
It was not.
All right. I suppose if the prison isn't cutting you off, then no one's dead. I'm going to leave it at that, I guess.
Let's just say...
Oh, no.
I am standing on a pile of souls to speak with you, Geoff, the Angry Man Garlock.
So you can answer. Mm-hmm.
Of souls. So where was I? I was saying David Lee Roth, 85. Now, I'm not
spine.
Going to discredit Yankee Rose.
Oh, you can't do that.
Not going to do that. But then the band truly did change, didn't they? When they brought Sammy Hagar into the fold in 1985, playing their first show ever at Farm Aid. Now, a lot of people will think that they played their first show at Live Aid, but they would be wrong and in a good need of a reckoning.
Vlad, I gotta say, you're really creeping me out. I swear that you murdered someone behind you, and you keep telling me that you're standing on a pile of souls, but you know a damn lot about Van Halen. It's very impressive.
It's the only thing I called in about.
Oh, have you called in to us before? Or are you calling in to other stations?
I've tried, but there's always what seems to be a robot just playing songs. They play Everybody Wants Some, and I would like to talk a little bit about Everybody Wants Some when it's over, but then it plays something like the only station in the land, 108.9 The Hawk, and immediately goes into China Grove by the Doobie Brothers, and I will not stand for it.
All right, fair enough, Vlad. Jeez, maybe take a chill pill over there, okay? We're just trying our best here.
Why don't you take a chill pill?
Why don't you just take a wolf man?
Over there.
All right, easy, easy, big fella, okay?
These walls cannot contain me.
Vlad, I'm going to hang up on you because now...
If you would like to talk in person, that can happen.
Okay, I'm hanging up now. I don't want to talk to you in person. No, I'm sorry, Vlad. Bye,
bye. See you soon.
Oh, God. Oh, jeez. 108.9 The Hawk talking to... I gotta say it. I think that was a vampire in the prison. And I gotta... I was feeling better than Art was...
Oh, my God. Did you say prison vampire?
Yes. Do you know about a prison vampire,
Art?
Oh,
my God. Well, let's just say I'm not prepared for that sort of visit tonight because prison vampires are the worst kind of vampires because they're in there just to feed. They don't have to be in the prison. Does that make any sense to you, Geoff? I know it's 1:38 at night, and your brain doesn't typically work very well in the morning. So I'm wondering what it's like right now.
I mean, I'm starting to see some colors.
Imagine being the most powerful being in the world, a vampire, and imagine choosing to be locked up in a place with tons of fresh meat. Tons of meat that's done a lot of bad stuff. Granted there.
Okay, all right, can you please stop laughing, please?
Wow. They choose to be there. That's the worst kind. Truly the worst kind. I've killed so many vampires, and I've only successfully killed one prison vampire. The other one wiped out my entire team. That's why I have cheese now.
Oh, you had a team of vampire hunters at one point.
I had a whole team. A coven, we like to call ourselves, and 14 people.
A coven? I'm just going to check. Are you a witch?
Well, I'm not saying I use any sort of dark magic, but when the time requires, it's there.
Okay. If it,
just like when the time requires.
108.9 The Hawk traffic with Art Spart.
Oh,
I'm always
you.
Here, and we're looking out at Blind Melon Lane. It is early. I just woke up, but Blind Melon Lane, a lot of traffic going up that right now. I don't know the reason. It does go right by the prison, so maybe there is something happening at the prison. I wouldn't know. I don't have my drones up right now to see, but a lot of traffic that way. Be careful. Also, be careful on 882. Just a car parked in the middle for no reason whatsoever. You know, that's the stuff that happens in the late night. And that is traffic on 108.9 The Hawk. I'm Art Spart, and I'm going back to bed.
It is
1:41. I've got time to sleep a little bit more. I may push it because I actually already did my duties. So, yeah, I'll be around.
All right, you got 4 minutes to get your beauty sleep there, Art. Godspeed. But please come back because I feel like as the night goes on, my list of worries just keeps on trucking. And I feel like I am just hanging out in a white room with black curtains here on 108.9 The Hawk. You're home for a classic rock. Hey, it's summer and that means one thing. The bugs are back and I want to get rid of them for you. So hire me, Filchy, of Filchy's Bug Out Exterminator Service. We will handle your extermination needs, except the gross ones. Look, I know that our original motto at Filchy's was, we get rid of all the bugs that bug you. But that was my dad's promise. Filchy Sr. Ever since he made me take over so he could retire in Boca Raton, well, I do things my way. Filchy Jr.'s way. I'll handle most of your bug needs, but anything that gives me the heebie-jeebies, no thank you. I'll come over, I'll do a comprehensive bug/vermin house check, and most things I'll deal with. But I promise you this, I see any caterpillars or those silverfish water bugs that just go flying under everything in your kitchen, or so help me God maggots, I am out of there. No questions asked. Ants, bees, yellow jackets, termites, rats, mice, etc. Look, anything on my fine list, I'll handle it. You get the filchy promise. They come back, then we come back until they're gone. Except for those real gross bugs. Ugh, like roly-polies? Yeah, you think they're just harmless? And why would they freak you out? Well, let's just say once I was drinking a Gatorade, original flavor. Somehow one got in there, I almost drank it, and blech, I get shivers just thinking about it. It's gross, and I ain't dealing. So good luck, Godspeed to you. Hey, I don't want to be an exterminator anyways. I was quite happy singing in Val Verde's premier Scorpions tribute band, Bug Out. It's like Blackout, but with Bug, because my dad Filchy Sr. was helping fund it. He thought it was a good promotion for the extermination company. Then he goes and retires. Apparently, I didn't understand all the money he was giving me. Well, it apparently had a cost. And that cost was that I needed to pay him back for it by taking over the family business. I told him, I don't like most bugs. I like rocking out to the Scorps. And he knew this. But, well, hey, man, you try explaining it to my dad. Filchy Sr. was just as tough on bugs as he is on me. So now I'm stuck killing bugs to keep the Filchy name alive. But I'm still rocking out with Bug Out on the weekends, and I'm still not gonna kill anything gross. Speaking of, no scorpions either. I love the band, but I ain't getting near a real one. So hire Filchy's Bug Out Exterminator Service. I'll maybe kill some of your bugs.
He's an assassin with a heart of gold. She's an assassin who just can't stop killing. When love crosses their path, will these two assassins kill each other with love? It's the world premiere of Hey Girl, It's Me this Saturday night, featuring Keanu Reeves and Amy Smart on Channel 8, your home for great shit.
It's me, Mickey Mac, with today's On This Day in Rock and Roll History. On this day in 1984, rocker David Bowie introduced his latest rock and roll persona, Todd. Todd was your average Englishman in 1984, who worked in accounting during the week and played football on the weekends with the guys. This was such a large part of Todd's deal that David Bowie actually released a single, Football Weekends.
It's a football weekend, everybody's playing with Todd. Another football weekend, 'cause we've been working so hard.
The single went to number one everywhere in the world, but that wasn't enough to keep Todd around, as Bowie let that alter ego go away after just 1 week. And Todd was never heard from again. That's On This Day in Rock History. I'm Mickey Mac for 108.9 The Hawk.
You're up at work and pissed that you're up and at work. But at least you're doing it with us. Hawk Overnights on 108.9. The Hawk, The Hawk, The Hawk, The Hawk.
Steve Miller Band, big old jet airliner here on 108.9. The Hawk. And I tell you, I wish I had a big old jet airliner to get me the hell out of here. This is Geoff the Anger Man Garlock doing your nighttime overnight drive-through slumber party massacre is what it feels like. I am in here. And of course, I have a phone call. Didn't have to ask this time, and I appreciate it. Please, God, do not let it be who I think it might be. Hello, welcome to 108.9 The Hawk. Who am I talking to?
This is Sergeant Galahad down at the Correctional Center, sir. We're just tracing the last call that came from this cell. Where'd it go? Who you?
All right, this is Geoff the Anger Man Garlock here at 108.9.
This is Sergeant Lieutenant Galahad of the Correctional Service.
Got that, sir. Yes, so I bet you're calling about Vladimir, are you?
Well, let's just say Vladimir was here, and a lot of my men were here, if you catch my drifts.
I don't know why you're being subtle with me. Are they dead?
Did he call?
They murdered?
Did he call? Did he say, hey?
He didn't exactly say hey, but he
did
call.
Did he say it like that? Did he say, like, if he said hey to you, how would you respond to that? What kind of hey would you come back with? Hey!
Oh, I mean, if he called with a hey, I go, you betcha, is
hey!
What I'd probably respond with,
All
but
right,
no.
Let's try that. Here we go. Let's try. Hey!
You betcha.
Hey!
You betcha.
Hey!
You betcha. But
yeah, so, sir, there is a serious vampire on the loose.
Yeah, that's what I am worried about. He did not call with
a hey. Do you think he's going to call back?
You should tell me. You're the one who was locked up in there with him.
I wasn't locked up. I just came, you know, I went over to Delaware Todd's, and I got me the Delaware, which is just crab, and it's boiled bread, and they just kind of mush it together in a ball.
Delaware mush ball. That is one of my favorites. Did you get it with pickles?
Did I get it with pickles? Hey, guys. Oh, no, they can't say nothing.
No, they're dead, aren't they? Can I ask you a question about your dead men?
These guys love pickles. Was that the question?
I'm sure.
Was the question, hey, do these guys like dead pickles?
No,
I mean, not
actually.
Dead pickles. Well, are pickles dead? Are they?
I know you've got a whole situation there, but I feel like you'd be good for morning drug time because you are fun.
What, really?
Yeah, I mean, you're asking the questions like, what are pickles dead? And I mean, is a cucumber dead? I mean, that's a good question. I have no idea. If we're killing cucumbers, I don't know if we should be eating them, if you know what I mean. I'm just saying over here.
Oh, hey, hold on. Private First Sergeant Reynolds is still alive. Hey, what did the vampire say before he killed you? He's coming. Said he's coming.
Okay, that was what I was worried about. Hey, can I ask you a question? Were the rest of them murdered by their necks being snapped?
Hey, Reynolds, was your necks being strapped? What'd you say, snapped or scrapped?
Snapped, not strapped, snapped.
Was your neck snapped? He's nodding yes.
Oh, that is not good for me.
Oh, it's not good for me, too, because these guys were going to be my groomsmen in my wedding next week.
Oh, well, congratulations. Early congrats, I have to
don't
say
I mean, you wouldn't be available next week to, I don't know.
DJ?
No, hell no.
Oh, well, excuse me.
I already got a DJ. I got one from the squirt, man. I got JJ Sharon.
He's going to be
doing
the worst.
I got JJ Sharon. He's great, man. I was going to say, could you be my best man?
I mean, we've just met here over the phone. I mean,
hey!
I guess most of your friends are dead now because of Vladimir the Vampire. Sure.
Well, I mean, it's a hell of a situation. It's a hell of a situation. It is. But I'd love to have these men at my side, but they are not. They're going in the ground.
How about this? You scratch my back, I'll scratch yours. I'll be your best man next week.
What's on your back?
It's a turn of phrase, much like I'm doing a wolf man.
I got a help. Wolf man's out? No, kids are snorting wolf man again?
Yes, so that's what I was alluding to now.
Oh, shit. Oh, hell. I'm going to have to call the commissioner now. This has just got even bigger. Hell, I was going to tell you all about the rash I get on my back from eating pickles.
Yeah, don't get into it. I've heard about these pickles.
You said that the kids are doing the wolf man again. I can't fucking believe. Well, that's definitely a bigger priority than this vampire. So
okay, so you're not going to come and scratch my back and come help me out is what I was
asking for. I will. I'll do whatever. I'll help you move into your next apartment or something. So we're doing the wedding just before we get off the phone here. We're doing the wedding down at Dingbats because I love comedies. And,
I love a reverent takes on modern mores as well. It's fantastic.
Yeah, man. So it's going to be so much fun. Hey, we'll be down there on Tuesday at 9. That's the best price you can get. So you're my best man. I'll see you there. We got to figure out this Wolfman thing. Commissioner, if you could just...
All right, I'm hanging up on him. He's just leaving me out here to dry. All right, people out there. Art, if you're going to wake up, I think now is the time to be waking up because we have a vampire coming here and you're not doing it. You're not.
No, I'm not. I'm not. I'm still sleeping. So
you're talking to me while you're sleeping. I just want you to know.
I have that ability. I do have that ability. I am 100% asleep at this moment and talking to you completely coherent, knowing everything that's around, because when you are a hunter, that is how you hunt. Going back to sleep, Art Spart on 108.9, The Hawk.
Well, people, not going to lie. Everyone told me I couldn't do it. Everyone told... Oh. Who's this? Hello, 108.9 The Hawk. Who's there? Jameson's.
What?
Is this Jameson's again? This is...
Yeah, this is Jameson's again. And finished lunch. I'm back. What's going on?
I mean, I gotta say, a lot Jameson's is. There's a vampire. Let me give a correction. A prison vampire is coming towards 108.9 The Hawk.
Not good.
He murdered most of the guards at the prison.
And Jim Morrison,
okay.
Was killed by a prison vampire.
It wasn't...
Because the vampire was a huge Doors fan. Now, here's the thing about prison vampires, Geoff. This is Wes...
Surprise. It was never a surprise. I always knew it was you. You son of a bitch.
No idea. You were like, "Who's this strapping young man giving me all the facts?"
I'm gonna give you a little hint. Next time, try disguising your voice literally at all.
I did. I went higher.
That was higher, Jameson's.
I went higher. Jameson's higher voice. It's up here, and I'm down here.
Oh, okay, yeah. A subtle difference that clearly I didn't pick up on.
It's why I've been in the business many, many years, and it's why you'll probably be done this year.
I think I might be done tonight, because I think a prison vampire is coming to murder me, and Art Spart will not wake up. Oh, by the way, did you know that Art is not only a cryptozoologist, but also a vampire hunter?
And probably a sorcerer.
And a sorcerer? Oh, my goodness. Well, I mean, this could only be good for me if he...
It's not, though. But did he tell you about his coven? Art's coven? He was called Art's coven. And, man, they were great. They actually had kind of a...
A second.
Yeah. It was a band, too.
That's what I was going to say. Right. Art's coven put out that LP.
Yeah,
Little bit of sorcery.
Yeah, that was a great
record. It's kind of like a skiffle sort of vibe to it.
They toured with Fairport Convention. Fairport is the tribute band. And they did a couple tours with Steel Ice Band.
Sure. Fairport Convention, of course, is playing at the Val Verde Enorma Dome. I still can't believe they sold out Fairport.
And then they were going to be the biggest band in the world. Art's Coven.
Wow.
Until a prison vampire who was a big Jethro Tull fan.
There you go.
Wiped them all out, leaving Art just so he would remember the pain. And never bring this up with Art. If you bring up the fact that he was on the cusp of being in the biggest band, I mean like bigger than the fucking Beatles. The Beatles would come and basically just crank off listening to Art sing.
That's a beautiful story.
I saw Ringo do it twice. I saw John do it once. He said he didn't. And I saw Paul openly do it on stage.
Wow. Ringo twice is a big one. That's just standard. That's just Ringo watching any band.
That's anything. Any band or any movie.
Watching Caveman with Ringo Starr. Yes. He made the movie so he had something to just crank it up.
He cranks away. You'll go see Thor Love and Thunder.
Oh.
He's going to be giving some love and thunder to himself, if you know what I mean.
I think I know what you mean, and I think you mean cranking on his yanker, if you know what I mean, while he's doing some Wolfman.
Yep. Oh, is Wolfman back?
Wolfman's back.
Have you ever done it?
I'm not sure. I'm still trying to catch up with the kids. Which drug is Wolfman?
Is its own thing. It's part crack. It's part speed. It's part peyote. It's part ayahuasca. It is part of everything, but a lot of opium as well. I did Wolfman pretty much all of 1989. I look at my hands. I know they're there. Cannot feel them.
Let me ask you this. Is the drug in Minority Report based off of Wolfman? Is it that little plastic thing you suck on?
Yep, that's it. You just say you suck it out. You remember those jugs of all of the fruit juice you would drink in the 80s?
Of course, nothing but bug juice.
That was the Wolfman.
Oh, so yes, most of my summer camp was based off of the Wolfman.
You did a lot of Wolfman.
That is why I saw a lot of colors.
Yep.
When I was in, but also I'm starting to realize I pounded a whole gallon of red bug juice before I started doing this show.
Yep.
Has all of this been in my head?
Probably not, because I'm calling from South America. It is very, very expensive. So who knows, really? I'm here. I know it's here.
You're right. The cost of your call definitely does prove it does. That it all was real.
Every second I can look at the bill and I could be like, oh, I called Geoff and I heard about his prison vampire that is on its way to murder him. And what, dessert? Okay, well, we'll do dessert in the den. We're doing a pudding. It's a banana pudding with some caramel on top. It's absolutely delicious. Scotty makes the best desserts. And
Scotty's down there with you the whole time? Scotty, yeah. Ask Scotty if he's been hearing my pleas in his nightmares.
Scotty, have you heard the pleas in his nightmares? I don't know what he's asking either, but... Shaking his head no.
That's son of a bitch. All right. I knew as soon as I started asking, it was a pointless ask.
Really pointless. Truly, truly pointless.
All right. Well, I guess go enjoy your pudding while I go possibly fight off a prison vampire.
Pudding. It's pudding time. Everybody eating pudding. Gonna put some in my mouth.
And that's how he left me. Wisp over here just taunting me. I gotta say, welcome to 108.9 The Hawk. Of course, this is Geoff the Anger Man Garlock. This is your overnight, and I'm not gonna lie. I don't know what's going on. Am I hallucinating? Am I on a bad Wolfman trip? Or am I about to be attacked by a prison vampire? These are the questions that I am left alone to handle. But I am also left alone to say, is that smoke on the water? You better believe it is, because this is Deep Purple, Mach 2 on 108.9, The Hawk.
He's an ex-special ops operative out for revenge. They are ex-pizza delivery men turned morgue workers. Together, they are raising bloody hell. Geoff Speakman, The Fat Boys, and Powers Booth. In Cold Justice, this Wednesday afternoon on the Channel 8 Afternoon Action Blowout. Channel 8, your home for great shit.
The Val Verde County Fair is back all this month at the Greater Valley Fairgrounds. Bring the family and experience the four F's. Food.
Oh man, you can eat it all at the fair.
Fun.
What, the fair's back? Oh shit, you see me there.
Farm animals. Yeah, that was the first time I've ever seen a pig that just outright stole my watch. And fault lines.
Boom, and the whole ground was shaking. Oh man.
See the petting zoo.
With hopefully no accidents this year.
Ride the Gravitrod 6000.
With hopefully no accidents this year.
Get your picture with the largest radish in Val Verde County.
With hopefully no accidents this year.
That's right. It's Val Verde Fair time. Check out the Four Horse Bands show with music from Foreigner, Styx, Kansas, and Ugly Kid Joe.
With hopefully no accidents this year.
Listen for your chance to win tickets on 108.9 The Hawk. The Val Verde County Fair.
Oh man, I love the fair.
Come for the fun.
Oh, I love the fair.
And leave because you should probably see a doctor.
Hi, I'm Chief Medical Person Michelle Sally Dabbs, back at it again. A lot of you wrote to us after our last spot in pure disbelief about the state of Val Verde Memorial Hospital. You said things like, this hospital is in ruins. Wait, is that really Michelle's real name? And you killed my grandma. Listen, we might not be an award-winning hospital, but let me assure you that Val Verde Memorial Hospital has never been more invested in the health and safety of you and your family. In fact, we care so much about you and your family that we made sure to run some tests. Accidentally. Turns out all of our COVID tests that we've been providing the Val Verde community are actually hepatitis C tests. But Silver Linings Playbook, Val Verde is free and clear of COVID. We think. Bad news, most of you have hepatitis C, so please make sure to check your Hotmails, your Gmails, and your Valmails for an email from oops@valverdememorialhospital.com for your test results. Val Verde Memorial Hospital.
If you're up this late, you're probably digging graves.
Hawk Overnights
on 108.9. The Hawk. The Hawk. The Hawk.
Led Zeppelin coming out of our Zep set within the evening. 108.9 The Hawk, this is Geoff Garlock. Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. Angry because I had to have a Zep set just to get my brain together. Three Zeps in a row because, people, I am freaking out. I don't know if I am even alive anymore. What are these noises that are surrounding me? Art will not wake up. I don't know happening.
Deep sleep over here.
Just Art keeps reminding me that he is sleeping. He keeps snoring like he's Huey, Dewey, and Louie over there. And I am not Scrooge McDuck. I do not have a giant money bin. And I am waiting for Launchpad McQuack to take me out of here, but no one is coming to save me. I feel alone. I'm waiting for someone, and I was hoping, just hoping, hoping that I wouldn't finally be feeling, on my last moments on Earth, the feeling that I've always kind of felt in my heart, that maybe I'm Geoff the Angry Man Garlock because I'm just alone in this world. So I don't know if it's the chili that Jason Gore got sidetracked with that's starting to hit me, because I gotta say, I also ate half a bowl of that chili while I pounded that wolf man, and I am not feeling good myself. Either
my god, who turned out the lights?
And that's what I thought. It's not just an existential crisis now. Art is awake and letting me know that there is no lights. I am
smoke filling the studio.
Smoke is filled.
Or is
course,
it fog?
Yes.
This is definitely fog. The first sign of a prison vampire. Followed by...
Yes.
Loudly played music of the band that they have chosen.
There it is. Yep. That is,
well,
of course...
Well, I'm going back to sleep.
No, Art, you can't leave me here. I'm left all alone. Just me and the fog and Eddie... Eddie Van Halen, of course, from the greatest bands ever. Oh, no.
And now, I'm in front of you.
Oh, my God. Who is that? Who is
it
that?
It is me, Vladimir.
Oh, yeah.
Continuing on the conversation of the world's greatest rock band, Van Halen, here on 108.9.
Oh, my God.
Rock.
I feel morally conflicted. I always want to talk about Van Halen, but I also feel like I'm in the middle of a Silence of the Lambs.
You sit there.
Meets Jackass 4. Meets Bram Stoker's Dracula. The greatest of all vampire movies.
Really?
What? That's just my opinion. I think
really?
It's interesting design when he's young.
Really?
You don't like the muscle armor that he's wearing? It's cool looking, right?
No.
All right, fine. Well, I guess we agree to disagree.
We will not agree to disagree. We will agree with my agreement. And the greatest vampire movie of all times. The one that truly, truly gets it right. Fright Night. Was that a laugh? Did you laugh when I said Fright Night? Is it because I say it like that?
It ain't helping.
The fact that it is Fright Night.
Everyone's
Night.
A critic. Everyone's
Fright
a critic. Yeah, your pronunciation is odd. I also...
That is how you say it. Say it.
Fright Night.
See, it comes right off the tongue that way. The tongue I will rip from your skull.
Yeah, that's all fine and good, but I mean, when's really the last time you've actually watched Fright Night, Vlad?
Tonight.
Or, I mean, is this just nostalgia
tonight.
For you?
Tonight.
You watched tonight. It tonight?
Tonight.
Tonight.
Right before I am given my first meal, they roll a TV cart into my cell.
Yes.
And it is filled with videotape cassettes.
Oh, you still get VHS?
The only way to watch.
Are you also one of those like VHS purists? too?
I only look at the Instagrams of people making new VHS covers for movies currently in theaters. Saw a very funny one for Stranger Things 4, something that will never really be on VHS, but why not make it? And why not sell it? Because there are some worthless nerds that will buy it, and then I will kill them. But anyway, let's talk a little bit about the Twister soundtrack. Very great soundtrack.
All right, yeah, I'm not going to lie. My fear very quickly has dropped down from you. I understand this whole prison vampire thing, but...
The best song from these... Music from the motion picture of Twister, known as The Dark Side of Nature. Here it is on 108.9, The Hawk.
Guess you're taking over, you nerd.
Oh, listen to that. Oh, that's good.
I mean...
Definitely the best thing that Sammy and Eddie and Alex and Michael ever did. Humans being.
You've lost a lot of power on me here.
Makes me remember a time when I was human.
Yeah.
And not immortal. And
was that around the time Fright Night came out?
Are you busting my vampire balls?
I mean...
It kind of feels like my vampire balls are being busted.
I mean, you got a weird pronunciation.
Are you...
Seem to be obsessed with social media, but like the dumbest stuff on social media.
Oh, okay. What is something good on social media?
Oh,
Geoff,
I mean,
the angry man, dead man.
You ever seen that titular movie lines Twitter? It's pretty funny.
What is it? Just like jokes of lines that nobody ever said in a movie.
You get it. You have seen it.
I think
it's not great, but it's not bad.
I was going to do that a long time ago when Zanga came around, and I just never got the motivation.
Yeah, I've been there too. I'm not going to lie. Again, you're losing some power on me because you're pulling the old "I could have done that as well" sort of move. It's just you're not much of a Where you gonna tell me you could have written Dark Side of the Moon too next?
Well.
I mean, that's the well is setting me up.
What do you do? You do a very thick bass line. You jingle some coins and then say it's a legend? It is not. The only Pink Floyd album. Momentary lapse of reason. Did you laugh again at Vladimir?
I just think I don't know. I mean, it's just when you get down to brass tacks, you're just like, oh, he's a scary prison vampire, but you got a lot of dumb opinions.
Okay, what else should I feel good about? What else do you think is dumb that Vladimir enjoys?
I mean, you don't like those videos of families going to sing at ice cream parlors, do you? They're ordered. I feel like I'm taking that as a yes.
I love them. Love them. Them.
And here comes the steak.
I've been stabbed!
Yep, and back to hell you go.
Art! Over our little Zepset break there, Vlad, Art taught me the trick of deception.
Mm-hmm. You
really
That's
how you get
job.
A vampire. Thank you very
you
much.
You did a wonderful job. What you do is you distract them with things that they love, and you make them think they're
right.
stupid.
I didn't
that
realize.
They are the dumbest things that could really be. But honestly, you have to admit, humans being slaps.
Oh, it's a great song.
That's something the kids say. They say
it slaps. While they're busting on Wolfman, they say it slaps. No, don't get me
Speaking
wrong.
Of
that
Wolfman,
one,
I'm going to take a little chug right now.
I had to bite my tongue on that one. That song does slap, but
wow.
I did not realize that this would be the greatest tactic is to just
amazing.
Just slightly fuck with amazing. People and their opinions, and it really gets their power down. I mean, I got to say, Art, I ain't scared of anything anymore. I feel like a superhero here.
Now you're a true hunter. And you know what else I'm not scared of anymore?
108.9 The Hawk traffic with Art Spart.
Well, Hawk Street's looking pretty good down by Rock Dolls. Looks like they're getting some new dolls in. It does look like it is the Weezer dolls, so maybe stay away from those. Not so fun anymore. And then looking over Kurt Hammett Peak Way. Beautiful look. If you're going up there to watch the suns, I highly recommend it. Just make sure you take Soundgarden Bluff. And sit right over there. There's a nice bench. You're going to enjoy the whole thing. For 108.9 The Hawk, that's Tramic. And I'm Art Spark.
And I'm Geoff the Anger Man Garlock. We got two more hours of overnight coming, but I tell you, I think it's going to be a fun ride for the rest of it. I feel like a weight has been lifted. And you know what? I got to tell you one thing. After all this time, BTO it up, because we are ready to take care of business here on 108.9 The Hawk. Geoff the Angry Man Garlock. Catch you on the flip-flop.